Ready? Start. Gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to extend a warm welcome to you all to this seminar. I know that all of you present here today have rich experience in the field of education. The present system of education had been evolved several decades ago. I am sure, therefore, that all of you will have felt the need for changing the system to suit the changed conditions of our society. Your rich experience in the field will go a long way in evolving a new pattern. I am confident that you will be able to contribute your considered views to overcome the difficulties we are facing today. If you apply your minds seriously, you will be able to evolve a system of education that suits to our requirements today. I know that it will not be possible to bring about any reformation immediately, but with your cooperation, I am sure it could be done in the near future. In this context, I may tell you that either the government or the university has only to look upon learned men. Like you and nobody else, you have great responsibilities towards the betterment of the educational system. At this seminar, you are at liberty to discuss all the aspects of education without any reservation. I hope that with the freedom you have, you will freely voice your feelings so that the standard of education in the country could be improved. All your opinions in this regard would be considered at a higher level and final decision taken for implementation. I request everyone of you to put your heart and soul into the problem and put your views in writing so that we could publish them as proceeding of this seminar. Para, as you know, I visited some of your colleges very recently. Then, more than enjoying your hospitality, I enjoyed the free of frank discussion you had with me. I learnt many things from you. It is only then that I thought of a seminar of this type where all of us could come together and discuss the problems facing us in a free atmosphere. Now, let us have a rapid review of the developments that have taken place during the past 2 or 3 decades in this regard. A number of committees had been set up. Although the findings of those committees were very valuable, they were found to contradict one another. So it was not possible to come to any conclusion. Therefore, what I wish now is that all of you put your heart and soul together and suggest the lines on which the future education policies of the country should be based. In this connection, we would have to take into account the ever-increasing number of students seeking admission into our schools and colleges, which has ultimately resulted in fall in the standard of education.